Absolutely, man. Absolutely. Listen, you know, just around the boxing world, man, in general, everybody's clamoring. Everybody's speaking. Everybody's somewhat foreseeing Vergil as being the guy, the next guy to possibly fight your fighter, Terence Crawford. I know I asked Hooker, I asked him, do you feel that you're being overlooked, man? Is a lot of fighter, or rather boxing fans and experts, giving you the chance to win? You know, how do you, what's your take on that?
Like Maurice said, it don't mind being an underdog, you know what I'm saying? Because that's all the pressure on Victor. He got a Vergil, whatever his name is. That's all the pressure that's put on him, you know what I'm saying? So, which is good. He got to go perform. He got to take chances. He got to push that button. He got to go. Once things ain't going to go his way, then how he's going to react. You know, and as far as looking over Maurice and looking towards Terence, he better watch out what's in front of him first before he get try to get to something that's going to wreck his career.
Wow. Well, listen, man, speaking about careers, we're talking about boxing, man. As far as when we think about the world of boxing, I like to call it, BOMAC, that we're in an era now, man, where we're in a social media era. We have a lot of these young prospects, contenders, you know, world champions that are calling each other out over the internet. But it's rarely do you see that you get an actual fight of this caliber where it's the best fighting the best. The fight fans come Saturday know the exact type of fight that they're going to see. It's going to be two warriors, two dogs when they go in the ring. Both guys are from Dallas. You know, you got Vergil Ortiz, you got a former world champion, and Maurice Hooker, who's training with the best, has the best stableman, some of the best sparring with Terence Crawford, Jermell Herring. I mean, do you think it's fair, man, that the criticism as far as, like you said, him being the underdog, I know you guys don't mind it, but does it bother you in a sense?
Man, we from the dirt, bro. You know, we all got it from the mud. You know what I'm saying? So 95% of us, not, well, 98.9% of us from the project. So, hey, we was born the underdog. We was born with a strike against us. You know what I'm saying? You know our society sees certain people, and we know certain people. So, hey, listen, man, whatever the boxing writers or the boxing fans or the hardcore fans, wherever they want to say, I don't mind it. We take it and run with it. That's it. That just make us train harder. And, hey, if you don't grind, you don't eat. You don't shine, then you must go to the back of the line. Hey, it's real simple. So, hey, we here to win, we here to shine. Hey, we here to be fucking upset. I promise you that.
Well, there you guys have it, man. Do you have any last words, any last shout-outs you want to give to anybody back home?
Shout-out to everybody back home in Omaha, Nebraska, everybody at B&B Boxing Academy back in Omaha, Jamel Herring, Steve Nelson, Get Better, Baby. Terence, I see you up in Colorado in the next couple of days. It's time to go to work, man. We stay working, you know what I'm saying?
But have a good one, man. It's your boy, Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, signing off with Brian BOMAC.